Another common misunderstanding that some well-meaning Christians have is that Jesus did away with the commandments. Some have even gone as far to claim that Jesus broke the Old Testament law to make a new one. Because of their ignorance of Scripture, these unstable people take certain passages and distort the true meaning. For example, some verses found in the Gospel of John and Mark, if not carefully examined, could lead many to believe this heresy.
John chapter 5, beginning in verse 5, says, "Now a certain man was there who had an infirmity 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew that he had already been in that condition for a long time, he said to him, 'Do you want to be made well?' The sick man answered him, 'Sir, I have no man to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up. But while I am coming, another steps down before me.' Jesus said to him, 'Rise, take up your mat and walk.' And immediately the man was made well, took up his mat and walked. And that day was the Sabbath. The Jews therefore said to him who was cured, 'It is the Sabbath. It is unlawful for you to carry your mat.' For this reason, they tried all the more to kill him. Not only was he breaking the Sabbath, but he was even calling God his own Father, making himself equal with God."
Most of us have heard the phrase, "context is key," or that we should always interpret Scripture with Scripture. When this is done properly, we can rightly divide the Word of God. We know that whoever keeps the entire law yet fails at one point is guilty of breaking it all. But according to some, Jesus, the Son of God, broke the Sabbath law. But is that what really happened? Did Jesus break the fourth commandment? No, of course not. You must realize that by saying Jesus broke any law would be calling him a sinner and therefore contradicting the entire Bible.
The Scriptures declare that Jesus is the Lamb of God, a lamb without blemish and without spot. He was tempted in every way as we are, and yet did not sin. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. So, if Jesus did not sin and break the law, why did the Jews say that he did?
And here lies the core issue. For us to interpret this correctly, we need to understand that in some instances, when the New Testament mentions the Jews and the law together, it is referring to what is called the Oral Law, or what would later become the Talmud or Mishnah.
The Oral Law is a legal commentary on the Torah, explaining how its commandments are to be carried out. Beginning around the time of Ezra, the Jewish rabbis reasoned that without an oral tradition, some of the Torah's laws would be incomprehensible. So, because of their reverence towards God and His commandments, they arranged a new set of laws around the Torah to keep from breaking the commandments. One of those man-made laws involved carrying objects on the Sabbath. It's important to remember that the actual Sabbath law of God never gives any specific details or commands pertaining to carrying objects. However, this new law was derived from several different places in Scripture and pieced together under a rule that stated it was forbidden to carry something from one domain to another on the Sabbath. So that's why the Jews said, "It is the Sabbath. It is unlawful for you to carry your mat." Unlawful regarding their derived man-made law, not the actual law of God.